The Auditor General's office says there's urgent need for compliance by mining firms in respect to tax associated obligations.
Just in 2015-16, we noted that about 34 billion, this is an estimate, about 34 billion in royalties were not collected. What happened was that we looked at the records of the ministry, we looked at the records at the Uganda Revenue Authority, who are responsible for export management, and we saw variances in terms of the amount of gold that was being reported at the ministry and what was being exported. And in the analysis, we realized that up to about 34 billion could have been lost. Now, just looking at what 34 billion can do.
There are related concerns that the economy could easily get distorted if the multi-billion shilling sector is not immediately streamlined.
I've actually been wondering what is making the dollar very strong these days. It has moved from 3.8 down to 3.6. It's these gold imports now. That distorts the entire macroeconomics. So it's not only affecting itself, it is affecting the rest of the economy. It's undermining exports of rice, of sugar, of every other thing that you may be thinking of. So if you don't tax it.
These concerns have been highlighted at the third annual Citizens Convention on Mining, which is underway in Kampala.
If I asked my friend Jane from Buhweju today about the bill, she's going to ask me in her native language, Bishogwe bill
nomutabanuwo. All these families have signed the MOUs with Moroto District Government. So annually, Moroto District Government will be parting with 5% of its dividends, whatever it has earned, for these families, so that you carry the communities with you for the lifespan of this factory.
State Minister in charge of Minerals, Peter Lokeris, has officiated at the event which is being held under the theme Amplifying Citizens' Voices, Harnessing Mineral Wealth Opportunities for Uganda.
And it is us now who are in the field to say this should be included, this should not be included, this should be included, and the government.
Reina Ojon, NTV Business.